talking about my dad. My dad is your typical dad. He thinks he's the funniest person in the world, and he's not. He's always making dad jokes. And we make fun of my dad for so many things. For example, he can never remember anything. He can never remember people's names. He can never remember where he put things. He is forgetting everything. He is also the biggest clean freak I know, and we make fun of him all the time because he always makes sure all of our stuff is clean and organized, but he is so messy. But the thing we make fun of my dad the most for is that he is the real life Cookie Monster. I have never met anyone, and don't think I will ever meet anyone, who loves cookies more than my dad. And growing up, my mom was always making cookies in our house because my dad was always craving them. And when she got tired of making cookies, my sister and I started learning how to bake and how to cook. So we would make cookies all the time. I think my mom gets a text from my dad every single day saying that he is craving cookies and needs cookies brought to him at work. Over break, he told us that we need to have a tray of cookies out in our house at all times, like at hotels, so he could just come and grab cookies whenever he wants. He is obsessed. And so I wanted to teach you guys how to make my dad's favorite cookie recipe. And so I called him on the phone and I said, "Dad, I'm giving a speech in class on how to make cookies. What's your favorite cookie recipe?" He says, and I quote, "That's a really dumb question. All cookies are my favorite kinds of cookies." I was like, okay, that doesn't help me. And so I decided to teach you guys how to make one of my dad's favorite cookie recipes. And I found this recipe about 5 years ago. And it's from a blogger. She has a blog called Baker Girl. And her recipe is called Chewy Oatmeal Chocolate Chip Cookies. But over the years, I have kind of modified and changed this recipe to my family's likes. And so this is my recipe of spiced oatmeal chocolate chip cookies. And I brought some for you guys today. Sorry if you decided to go gluten-free after Holly's speech. These are not gluten-free. I also have the recipe, so I'll just start one on one side. And just take one, because I don't think there's enough for more than one. So in my house, we eat cookies so often that we needed a healthier substitute for butter, because butter is so unhealthy for you. So we started replacing coconut oil for butter in our recipes. And the healthy eating page from the San Francisco Gate says, "You may substitute virgin coconut oil for butter in many baking recipes, adding a healthier blend of fatty acids. However, coconut oil still contains a very high proportion of saturated fat. Although the fatty acid responsible, lauric acid, may help improve your blood cholesterol profile and promote the use of fat for energy. We love using coconut oil because it's so much healthier than butter and you can't taste it at all. Sometimes we'll do half butter, half coconut oil, but in this recipe I used 100% coconut oil and you can't even tell." So we're gonna start with a half cup plus 6 tablespoons of softened coconut oil. You wanna make sure that your coconut oil is softened and not melted because coconut oil is really temperamental and can melt just by the warmth of your hands. So if you have to soften it in the microwave, just be careful. To that, we're gonna add a half cup of granulated sugar and 3/4 cup of firmly packed brown sugar and cream that together. Then we're gonna add in 2 eggs and 1 teaspoon of vanilla and continue mixing. While that is mixing, I like to start mixing my dry ingredients in a separate bowl. So we add 1.5 cups of flour, 1 teaspoon of baking soda, and 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Now, since these are spiced oatmeal chocolate chip cookies, I like to add in 1.5 teaspoons of cinnamon, 1/2 teaspoon of nutmeg, and 1/4 teaspoon of ground ginger. I love the flavor and warmth that these spices add to the cookie. My brother refers to these as the cinnamon cookies because the cinnamon and the spices stand out so much and they just complete the flavor of the cookie. Once our dry ingredients are all mixed, we are going to combine our wet and our dry. And you want to make sure to add the dry in sections. So you just want to add a little bit and then mix it and then keep adding a little bit more. Because if you were to add all of the dry ingredients at once and then turn the mixer on, the flour would go everywhere and you'd have a huge mess on your hands. And once we add the dry, you're gonna have a pretty sticky dough, and that's because we're gonna add in 3 cups of dry rolled oats. And the oats make up the bulk of the cookie. They make it really hearty. And my dad loves really hearty cookies with lots of ingredients. He hates like plain bland cookies. After we add the oats, we're gonna add in 1 cup or more of chocolate chips. And if I want to make my dad really happy, I'll add in 1 to 1.5 cups of chopped nuts. We like pecans in my house, but any nut will work. I didn't add them in these just because I know people are allergic, but if you're going to add nuts, you would do that here. Sometimes you also like to add dried fruit or shredded coconut or like mini M&Ms just to switch it up and play around with the flavors and textures. After that is all combined, we're going to start scooping the cookie dough. So using a cookie scoop, you want to scoop the cookies onto a lightly greased baking sheet or use a baking mat like a Silpat mat on your cookie sheet, and you're going to bake them at 350 degrees for 9 to 11 minutes. Once they're done cooking, you want to take them out of the oven and let them cool on the cookie sheet for 1 to 2 minutes and then transfer them to a cooling rack. If you're in my family, you've probably already eaten one or two before they've even made it off the cookie sheet. I'm not kidding when I say that we inhale cookies at my house. I've even gotten yelled at for not doubling a cookie recipe before, so it's pretty interesting in my house. And then you can store them in an airtight container like I did or in a Ziploc bag. If you can't eat them all before they go dry, you can put them in the freezer just pull them out whenever you want. But I'm almost sure that these cookies will be a crowd pleaser. They are soft and they're chewy and they have so much spice and flavor. They're like the perfect fall cookie thanks to the cinnamon and nutmeg and ginger. And they're a little bit healthier thanks to the coconut oil, so you can eat a couple more of them if you like. I'm almost sure this will become your next go-to cookie recipe.